When I talked with her, she was very calm. And I told her, I said, you do what you have to get that airplane under control. I said, you find somebody that knows how to fly, you call me back. Because, see, I flew that airplane. Not that particular one, but I flew that type of airplane. And I said, I can tell somebody how to program the computer to land that airplane. You call me back as soon as you find somebody that can fly it. And I'll tell you how to program it and set you up to land. I'll do whatever I can. And I just said, you do what you can to get that airplane under control.
And you didn't get a call back.
No. And then the next thing I know, I heard on the TV that Flight 93 had crashed.
They were doing a search in hopes of finding survivors. I know some of the people that I could see were very upset about it. Because in the fire service, we always train to save lives. And just to look on a lot of the faces there. We knew we couldn't save anybody.
Now, for me and for my family and for my grandchildren and their children, it will be Lauren's final resting place. It's like my mom and dad's, part of my fabric. And so that will be there. And I think it will be a beautiful park. And it will be a remembrance for generations and generations of 9/11 and our little part of what role we played in the only victory of that day. And it will continually compel people. It does, it draws, it has a meaning about it that will compel people to come and honor our loved ones.
And when I stood at the site this time and I saw the way nature was starting to take over again, starting to engulf the hole, the pit, starting to just like moss covering some charred things, and the dirt wasn't smelling like fuel anymore, it's smelling like earth again, and there were butterflies everywhere, and it was like, yep. It felt, for lack of a better way of explaining it, just so zen to me that, life is so, it's not permanent, it isn't, but there is this cycle of the whole process, and the cycle is working itself again, and it felt safe and good and comforting and peaceful and nurturing and calming to me.
What happened that day is something that we should never forget. We shouldn't forget it because of those people whose lives were lost, the families that were involved. But we should never forget it so that we as a nation know that we are always at danger unless we stand up for what we believe. And that's exactly what those people did. They stood up for the rest of us by letting the terrorists know that they were not going to get the upper hand.